On this week's show, GM commits to a fleet of self-driving Chevrolet Volts in Canada, Japanese bureaucracy holds up the hydrogen revolution, and a Nissan LEAF deal that's just too good to miss if you live in Colorado. These stories and more coming up next on 10. Enjoying today's show on YouTube and want to read the stories we're referring to today? Just head to our website at transportevolve.com/TEN, where you'll find today's show notes, as well as links to the latest future car news, buying guides, tech primers, and car reviews. It's Friday, December 4th, 2015. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and since we didn't have a show last week, this week we're covering the big stories from the past 2 weeks. So I'll try and cram in as many as I can. Strap on in! Just before Thanksgiving last week, Tesla Motors announced the start of general production of its Model S electric SUV, disclosing full pricing for both the entry-level Model X 70D and Model X 90D for the first time. While the Model X has been in production since September, all the cars made thus far have been special edition models, packed with high-end technology and commanding a similarly high price tag. But assuming you've already put down a $5,000 deposit on the Model X, you can now configure your dream car via Tesla's online configuration app. Pricing starts from $80,000 for the 70D, which comes with a 220-mile range and a 6-second 0-60 miles per hour time. Add in all the bells and whistles, plus a longer-range battery pack and ludicrous 3.2-second 0-60 time, and you'll have little change from $130,000. So if you're looking to buy, you'd best get saving. For nearly a year now, we've heard rumours suggesting BMW is preparing to beef up the range of its i3 electric car, something that even BMW boss Harald Kruger has confirmed himself. But last week, British magazine Autocar claimed that the increase in range will come from a brand new battery pack and drivetrain that is far more efficient than those used in current model year BMW i3, yet stores exactly the same amount of energy in terms of the battery pack. The claimed additional range, more than 124 miles per charge, is unlikely given an identically sized battery pack, unless BMW has managed to significantly reduce the weight of this new, next-generation pack compared to the original. Given Autocar confused the terms energy density and power density, we're also not sure if its sources are 100% reliable on this one, but it's certainly an intriguing rumour that we're keen to prove true or false. Thanks to their drive-by-wire control systems, electric cars make ideal autonomous vehicle testbeds, and so far, we've seen autonomous versions of everything from a Nissan LEAF to a BMW i3. This week, we were able to add the Chevrolet Volt to the list of autonomous vehicle prototypes, with the news that General Motors Canada would be putting a fleet of autonomous Volts on the roads, collaborating with their colleagues south of the border in Michigan. The work of GM's Canadian technical team will form the basis of a much larger autonomous vehicle program, which will include curbside pickup and drop-off using Volts through a car-sharing app. We might not see the results of this program on the roads in the short term, but as always, we're excited to see yet another autonomous vehicle program get the go-ahead. Staying with autonomous vehicle technology for a second, we told you last week about a new recruitment drive at Tesla Motors, specifically to find hardcore engineers to join Tesla's Autopilot autonomous drive program. The announcement made by Tesla CEO Elon Musk on, yep, you've guessed it, Twitter, is a major push from the Californian automaker in order to be the first to bring fully autonomous drive capabilities to market. With its Autopilot beta now already in the hands of the public, Musk has said that the Autopilot software team is undergoing a full ramp to achieve generalized full autonomy. While no prior experience with cars is necessary for candidates, Musk did mention that he'll be interviewing engineers for the role personally, and that the Autopilot team reports directly to him. So, if the thought of being drilled by Mr. Musk scares you, it's probably not your dream job, okay? Sorry. It reminds me in some ways of the humble Morris Minor, the very first car I bought, and as such, the diminutive bubble-shaped Mitsubishi i-Miev shares a special place in my heart. But this week, we told you that the Mitsubishi i-Miev has been finally killed. Mitsubishi has announced its intent to shelve the four-seat urban runabout along with the gas-guzzling Lancer sedan. The reason? A push towards crossover SUVs in the Japanese automaker in order to capitalize on the massively popular vehicle segment. While we're sure many will be as sad as we are to see the i-Miev go, there is at least some good news coming out of its demise. Of those new SUVs, Mitsubishi plans to offer two of them as a plug-in hybrid and one as an all-electric model to fill the space left by the tiny and low-volume plug-in. And if that means more people are buying plug-ins than before, we can't complain, can you? Of all the world's nations, Japan is undeniably the most bullish about the prospects of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, and with good reason. Toyota and Honda, two of the largest fans of hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, are based there. Yet, while the Japanese government, led by Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, wants Japan to shift its transportation and energy infrastructure to become a hydrogen nation, we told you this week that plans to roll out hydrogen filling stations across Japan are being held up by bureaucracy over just what rules the small-scale hydrogen filling stations must adhere to. Regulations for larger-scale installations are now set in stone, but since the majority of refueling stations will be this smaller size, there are few refueling stations accessible to the public right now. And that means that cars like the Toyota Mirai fuel cell sedan and Honda Clarity FCV are hardly practical right now. Instead, if you want a clean, green car in Japan, electric is still your best choice. At least you can fill that up at a household outlet if you really need to. For as long as there have been electric cars on the road to buy, the mile-high city of Denver and the state of Colorado in which it's located have been known for their supportive attitude towards electric vehicles, sporting, in fact, one of the highest-value state electric car incentive programs in the whole US. But on Black Friday last week, Drive Electric Northern Colorado, a community-wide initiative designed to encourage the adoption of electric cars in the region, announced a deal which is, frankly, simply too good to miss if you happen to live in the area. Put your name down to buy a new 2015 Nissan LEAF S with quick charge package before the end of December, and you'll end up paying an effective price of just $10,623 after incentives and discounts. The deal, originally negotiated as part of an exclusive deal with local businesses, has proven so popular that T.E.N decided to open it up to members of the public too. And while we don't ordinarily feature deals on this show, this one is so cheap, it's more than $4,000 less than we paid for a two-year-old high-end LEAF earlier this year. Enough said. Following on from its high-end XC90 plug-in hybrid earlier this year, Volvo announced a brand new S90 luxury sedan this week, complete with range-topping T8 plug-in hybrid variant. While we're already hearing from plug-in fans that this particular model, which manages around 20 to 25 miles in all-electric mode, is something of a letdown for the Swedish automaker, we're mentioning it here today because it also includes some impressive new safety features designed to keep the car and its occupants safe. In addition to building on the XC90 safety features, the S90 features large animal avoidance detection, which should cut down on accidents involving large wild animals like deer or moose, while a new autonomous drive feature offers to auto-steer on a variety of roads up to speeds in excess of 80 miles per hour. And while we're sure most wanting a plug-in with autonomous tech will still opt for a Tesla Model S, it's good to see other automakers offering their own takes on both revolutionary technologies. And finally, we've criticized South Korean automaker Hyundai before on this show for its tendency to turn pretty much anything into a press release. But this week, we think it may have outdone itself by proudly announcing its Hyundai Tucson FCV has set a brand new speed record for a production hydrogen fuel cell vehicle. The speed? Wait for it. An eye-popping 94.6 miles per hour, which, if we're honest, isn't all that fast. Indeed, we're pretty sure most of you watching this today have pushed your own car, at some point or other, into the triple digits, rather legally or not. But if you're a fuel cell fan, perhaps this record is noteworthy. But if we were to advise Hyundai, however, we'd have refrained from celebrating a double-digit land speed record. Certainly this year. Don't you agree? Well, no records from me today, except perhaps one for falling asleep from exhaustion when today is done. We'll be back next week at the usual time, but in the meantime, you'll find all the news that's fit to print at our website at www.transportevolve.com, catch up with us on Twitter at @transportevolve, or check out our latest shows on our usual YouTube channel. And if you liked what you saw today, consider keeping us independent and impartial by visiting our Patreon page at patreon.com/transportevolve and pledging your support from as little as $1 per month. If everyone who watched this video made that pledge, it'd not only fund some great new shows, but also our upcoming trip to CES and allow us to expand our staff too. So go on, help us out. Otherwise, we're not going. As always, there's a lot we haven't managed to fit into today's show, including Elon Musk's proposals for carbon taxation to rid the world of fossil fuels, Faraday Future plans to unveil its enigmatic car at CES, and if we have the money, we'll be there to cover it, a New Orleans resident fights for the local city council over electric car charging stations, and we give you our beginner's guide to shopping for and installing your charging station for your electric car at home. So when we're done, be sure to head to our site to read them all. Thanks for watching. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Have a great weekend, and until next time, keep evolving.